Hello guys, look at these robots. These robots were all built using pieces from Vex. This robot is called Vex IQ, and the pieces I used were all from Vex. So if you guys can come over here and see the pieces. Okay, so in this box over here, we have the controller as well as many other pieces. We also have all of these sensors. Then in this box, we have all of these pieces. Also, we also have many other boxes with much more pieces. As you can see, and there are also more boxes which provide more tires, wheels, pieces just in general, as well as wiring. And I also have more boxes, so over here there are even more pieces. And finally, the last box. And over here is a very simple basic robot that can be built within 5 minutes. You can either make it work autonomously, or you can use the controller to make it move around. And you can program it to make it move autonomously using the brain. Basically, over here is the brain. You can use your laptop, you can connect it, you can open Vex Code IQ, put the program inside the brain, and then you can run it at a later date. Or if you want, you can just use the controller to make it move around. And there are also multiple sensors that are included. For example, the touch LED. What this does is that it's kind of like a button. For example, you can touch it, you can make a robot move by making this touch, or anything else you want. There's also a obstacle sensor. What this does is that this detects all colors, for example, white, black, red, and can also be used for sumo robots. There is this bumper sensor, which is kind of like a button, but this can be used as maybe a sumo robot as well to make it, if it were, you know, pressed, it could maybe turn around, move back, or try doing any of the above. And finally, we have the distance sensor. What this does is that it finds anything in front of it or around it, and you can program it on those things. We also have a bunch of different motors that can help the robot move. We also have a bunch of different robots that help the robot move, and we have a bunch of different types of tires. For example, we have the classic tire. We also have different types of tires, if I can just find them. 1 second. We also have this type of tire, which is used for turning around easily. We also have another classic tire. We also have tiny tires. We also have gears, as well as many extra wires. Okay, so this robot has 5 motors. It has one on the side to make the ramp move up or down. It also has 4 motors on the bottom to make it move left, right, forward, or backward. And it also has a few sensors. For example, our distance sensor. This can be used to find anything in front of it. This was previously a sumo robot, so we use this to find the opponents or the opposing robots to, you know, make it move forward. We also have the optical sensor on the bottom, which is used to find the white line to stop our robot from moving past it. And you can also use a gyro sensor. If you want, you can also integrate it inside the brain. Oh, I forgot to tell you that Vex has 2 different versions. It has the version 1 and the version 2. This over here is the version 2. Sadly, I don't have the version 1. Okay, so as you guys can see, there are some really incredible pieces, and this robot is super high quality, and the brain is incredibly easy to use and incredibly easy to program as well as update. The sensors are incredibly accurate with their readings and also super easy and fun to use. And now the only thing that's missing is the coding, so let's get right into it. Okay, so over here is the coding platform, but before we start doing that, I want to show you guys something. So we go over to vexrobotics.com. There is something I really like about Vex. It is that it has its own specified kit for each age group. So as you guys can see, there is a specified kit for each grade. For example, there's for pre-kindergarten, there's a specified kit, there's for grade 3, a specified kit, grade 6, and grade 9. This means that this has a vertical educational path, and that also means that I don't have to go through many IDEs or platforms. And this is one of the main challenges in robotic education. And all of these coding platforms are free as well as compatible with any device you have, such as Apple, Microsoft, Android, or Chromebox. And now we're going to get back to coding. And since we're talking about Vex IQ, we're going to be using its own platform. So we go to it. Over here is the Vex IQ platform for coding. As you can see, there are many different sections for coding, such as the looks, the events, the control, the sensing. Okay, now if I grab anything, for example, a forever block, then if we go to the code viewer, we can check our code in Python or C++. So as you guys can see, this is a great platform and all, but it's missing the curriculum. So a great platform without curriculum is not exactly that great. And so, do you guys think that they have the curriculum? And so the answer is yes. They also provide a really amazing curriculum. Okay, and now we're gonna see an example. So if we go to Vex IQ, then if we press learn more, over here we can find these things. So if we press on teach with Vex IQ, so as you guys can see, this is going to provide you with everything that you need from the curriculum, the STEM labs, the teacher guide, the basic guide, as well as the certificate. And this is also the same for every other robot. Do you guys think that they have robotic competitions? Well, yes, they do. They have some of the largest robotic competitions on the planet. For example, there is this one, as well as this one, and many more. I would like to show you guys something very interesting. Now, if we go back to, over to the curriculum, and what I really like about it is that it's going to take you step by step. It's first of all going to be showing you how to make a simple machine, and then it's going to be making a motorized machine, and finally, it's going to make that motorized machine into a smart machine. And this is a really nice and simple way to teach kids about robotics. And I forgot to show you guys about the Vex Go. Basically, what these two boxes are is that these two boxes make up one kit. And this kit is for the grade 3 and above. And many children would like this kit because it's very colorful and the curriculum is easy to understand. All right, and now, what are you meant to do if you don't have the Vex IQ or the Vex Go or any of the others? Are you meant to stop learning? No, because I have an answer for you. If you open up VR Vex, you'll be able to find something called Vex Code VR. Basically, what this does is that this makes a simulation of a robot with whatever code you want. And so even if you don't have this kit or any of the others, you can still learn about Vex Robotics. So as you guys can see, Vex is incredible because it not only provides kits for each and every age group, it also provides the curriculum for each and every age group. And even if you don't have these kits or the robot itself, you can always use vrvex.com. It also provides with some of the largest international competitions. Well, what else do you need? Okay, and now I'm going to be showing you guys the code for the sumo robot. So if we head over to Vex IQ, I'm going to just quickly open up my code. So basically what happens here is that in the beginning, our crane is going to be falling down after 5 seconds. And then it's going to be starting up the sensors. It's going to be searching for the opponents, trying to push them off while not moving out of the white line. And I'll be explaining this robot in details in the upcoming video. Stay tuned until the next video. Bye bye.